started the program, the Youth Against Violence program, approximately 2.5 years ago to fight the influx of gang violence in our community. We seen that a lot of our young people wanted more. They wanted to be involved in this program in a way as to volunteer. They showed to us that they had a heart of giving. And therefore, we brought them on at first as just helping out with the Youth Against Violence program, the first program. But we knew we had to give them more. Grace be to God, we were blessed by Miss Tracy, Miss Roberta. Miss Roberta being a volunteer of the Youth Against Violence program, the first component. She approached me and her and Miss Tracy had already developed a leadership program.
One of our goals with this program is to educate, encourage, and empower young people to chart their own destinies in becoming successful leaders in their various chosen career paths. It was important to me that this group had a firm grasp on the concepts of good leadership. We clearly defined our beliefs and values relative to what leadership means, as well as defining the necessary characteristics for good leadership, like honesty, integrity, courage, confidence, creativity, trustworthiness, and forward thinking.
The three most important lessons I learned was how leadership differs from just bossing people around. A leader must demonstrate characteristics such as basing his or her actions on morals and reason, encouraging honesty, and displaying confidence in all he or she does. The two most important keys to effective leadership are trust and confidence and effective communication in order to create a vision for others to follow. As a college student, I apply these lessons in order to network myself in front of my classmates and my professors, so if I decide to use them as references on my resume, when I go in for an internship or an interview, they will be able to emphasize my character and leadership skills.
While I was in high school, I had some leadership qualities, things like being broad-minded, intelligence, confidence, but all those things, being here at the Youth Against Violence Leadership Program, I learned how to own these skills and be a better leader. And I learned being here is, like, being here, I learned that being a leader isn't much of a requirement for me, it's more of a lifestyle.
First of all, I would like to acknowledge Chief Sparks and Arthur Powell for their vision and courage to make a difference in the lives of our young people. I would also like to thank Roberta White and Tracy Rookert for the warm welcome and seamless transition into the Youth Against Violence program. Most of all, I would like to thank the young people in our group for the profound privilege of allowing me to do what I love to do, and that is to help young people see that anything is possible in their lives. While working with our young people, we covered topics such as leadership, time management, and my favorite, goal setting. I believe that when anyone is focused on the road to their goal, distractions are minimized. Without goal setting in my life will be very different and controlled by others and circumstances that were not beneficial to my life. During our goal setting class, our young people generated exciting goals that inspired me, and I look forward to witnessing them establish themselves as leaders in our community.
The first thing I learned about goal setting is that it has to be specific. My goal within the next 2 years is to graduate high school and then be accepted into Full Sail University for music engineering. Next, I learned that a goal has to be measurable. It is measurable by completing high school and then being accepted into Full Sail University. Next thing I learned about goal setting is that it has to be achievable. Challenges that I may see is obtaining a 3.0 GPA average for my junior and senior year, and then obtaining the funding for Full Sail University. I can overcome my challenges by studying hard and completing my assignments. I will fund my education by working for my junior and senior year and then being accepted into Full Sail University.
Well, my goal is to open up my own catering business, and I want to achieve success and be capable of starting from scratch and have my own business in Atlanta, Georgia. I would have to get a business license and finish school, finish college. I want to be able to have my business within the next 5 years. I want to be able to say that I achieved my goal, and I want people to know that I'm capable of everything that I said that I would do.
Well, my two goals I set for myself to achieve entrepreneurial success is, one, is to first finish out school at West Georgia College for my bachelor's in mechanic automotive. And my second goal is to actually go to Australia College of Georgia to get my bachelor's in business.
Weeks ago, we embarked upon a journey to excite, ignite, and redirect the lives of 9 extraordinary young people. We focused on leadership, goal setting, and accountability. We discussed the importance of taking ownership of one's decisions, and we instilled in them the importance that every decision has on one's life. The importance of being able to regroup quickly, put a plan in place to be able to move forward. Life should be, and this program is, about redemption. It was really important for each of the instructors to instill in our students the knowledge of the importance of being able to regroup quickly when mistakes are made, rebuilding one's life and not using that one incident to define who they are. Moving forward, having positive energy, and hopefully we've given them the skill sets to be able to do that.
During my prison incarceration, I ran into a lot of young men that had dealt with some of the same issues I had to deal with coming up as a young man. Lack of love, nurturing, support from family members, the absence of a father. I basically committed myself to trying to deprogram a lot of young men of how they had been taught how to be a man in the streets, basically by being involved with gangs or selling drugs, and just give them the realities about the consequences that come with being involved in those type of activities and the severity of it, you know, of either going to prison for a long time or either losing their life in the streets.
Well, what I learned is first impression is always the best impression. You should, if you are engaged with a group, you will have more opportunities, have more access to more opportunities. But if you don't, then you won't be able to get too far to where you want to reach your goal at. So if more people want to work with you, you know, you have to be more open and less, you know, stay to yourself, but you know, you have to be more open, trying to meet new people and get into more things for you can reach your goal and become bigger than what you want to become.